I'm curious to find out if ChatGPT has the ability to be able to assist me in diagnosing and ultimately repairing an engine and how it would go about that process. Therefore, in today's video, we'll put it to the test and see if it can troubleshoot, diagnose, and lay out a step-by-step process for me to follow on this Stihl MS201T chainsaw. I found it in a Verge collection with a number of other chainsaws about a year or so ago, and it's sat in my shed ever since, and therefore I think it's going to be the perfect platform to see if AI, in this case ChatGPT, can diagnose and help me get it up and running. And I'm really curious to see if the process that it recommends is firstly any different to how I would go about the repair myself, and secondly, maybe I'll learn something new along the way as well. Now I have to swap the phones because the one that's recording now has ChatGPT loaded. So we'll do that and we'll see what response it gives. I found a Stihl 201T chainsaw on a Verge collection. I have no idea what's wrong with it or why it's not working. Can you give me a concise step-by-step guide to troubleshoot, inspect, repair, and hopefully get this chainsaw running as well as it was before?
Certainly, here's a step-by-step guide.
1. Visual inspection. Check for obvious damage, leaks, or loose parts. Fuel system. Ensure fresh fuel mix is used. Inspect the fuel lines and filter for blockages or cracks. Air filter. Clean or replace the air filter if it's dirty. 4. Spark plug. Remove and inspect the spark plug. Replace it if fouled or damaged, and check for a strong spark. Compression test. Verify the engine's compression. Low compression may indicate internal issues like worn rings or seals. 6. Exhaust and muffler. Check the muffler and spark arrestor for blockages that could restrict exhaust flow. Pressure and vacuum test. Perform these tests to check for air leaks in the crankcase and seals. Carburetor. If the engine still doesn't start, clean and possibly rebuild the carburetor to ensure proper fuel delivery. Ignition system. Check the ignition coil and wiring for issues. Final assembly and test. Reassemble and test run the chainsaw. Make adjustments as needed. These steps should help you identify and fix the issues. Let me know if you need more details on any step.
Well, the first step was the initial inspection. Let's pop clutch cover off. This also gives us access to see the cylinder fins and make sure they're not blocked or damaged. Nothing stands out there. There's no major cracks or damage or parts missing. Let's take the recoil cover off. And we'll be able to see if there's the flywheel missing, the coil missing, or any damage to any of the fins on the flywheel. Coil's present. There's no wiring damage, at least here. Sometimes they can catch on the edge. Flywheel's in place and there's no fins missing. And it's tightened down. Nothing obvious on this side either. And just have a quick look on the underside and make sure there's no cracks in the tank, which could be why it was thrown away. There's nothing else I can really see that would cause it so far to be thrown out. Let's check the fuel system. Couldn't see any fuel from the outside of the tank. There's a tiny drop in there. Let's see if it's straight fuel or whether it's been mixed. No, nothing coming out there. So the tank is pretty much dry. So that's a bit unfortunate because oftentimes that can give you an indication if it's been straight gassed. Let's have a look at the fuel filter. Certainly doesn't look too bad, certainly doesn't look blocked, but we'll test it. And ChatGPT also recommended we inspect the lines. We'll give those a pressure test as well. Just make sure they're not leaking. So we'll use some forceps and that'll stop the fuel line going back in the tank. And we'll pull the fuel filter off and we'll give it a pressure test. So this is the Mighty Vac. I've spoken about it a bunch of times. Links in the description to Amazon if you want to grab yourself one, and all the other tools that I use in today's video. Now, this fuel filter should instantly let all the air through. It shouldn't hold any pressure. And it's not. So we haven't got a blocked fuel filter. So we know that one's okay. That wasn't the issue. Now we'll repeat that test, but on the fuel line. Now this time it should hold pressure, meaning that there's no leaks in the fuel line. There's no leaks where the barb joins the carburetor, no leaks in the gasket or past the needle. And again, there's no leaks there. So we know the fuel system is tight and there aren't any blockages, at least in the fuel filter. Air filter next. Well, it's there. It could do with a clean. I'm just going to give this a quick washout. Just a little bit of dish soap and some warm water is all it really needs. With how hot it is today, it's only going to take 20 minutes to dry, so we'll leave it there. Spark plug next. We'll just make sure it has got spark and that the coil's not failed. There's certainly a fair bit of carbon on there. It's unlikely someone's going to throw such an expensive saw out without testing that the spark plug's the issue, but you never know. Let's check that it has actually got spark and that the coil's not failing. Oh, there was a spark. Certainly has spark. Next suggestion from ChatGPT was a compression test. Now, I haven't got an adapter that's this small, so we will use this one. And I'm going to do my best to press that against the spark plug threads and see if we can get a reading. So what I'll do is use my foot to press this. This is going to be tricky. It's going to go flying. Can't get that in there. Certainly not the easiest way of doing it, but that's it. Well, we're already nearly 150, so compression is excellent. Just under, actually, 142. That's more than enough to run. So far, there's nothing that stands out. It's got great compression, fuel filter's good, spark's good. Spark plug's got a bit of carbon on it, but I don't think that's the issue so far. Next is to have a look and see if the muffler's blocked and see if we can have a look at the exhaust port, and then we'll have a look inside the cylinder too. Let's start with the spark screen. Make sure there's no blockages there. Nothing wrong there at all. It's really nice and clean. To take the muffler off on these, you just have to take this cover out. There's two T27s on the bottom, and the muffler slips right out. Gosh, these are tight. Oh! And now we can just pull the muffler out. The only way I can see into incredibly tiny and tight is through this little hole. So let's get the bore scope out and we'll get a really good view of the piston and any carbon that's formed inside there as well. Ah, well, there's your issue. The piston is absolutely hammered. And even if you could get this to run, surprisingly, the compression was as good as what it was. It's not going to run properly, it will keep stalling, and ultimately, it does need to be rebuilt. The question now, though, is how did it score like that? How did it get so bad? Is it an air leak? Was it a fuel restriction? Something like this, with what I can see so far on the saw, tells me that it's more than likely been straight gassed. Someone's put fuel in without any oil, and that's what's caused this seizure. Now, let's quickly do a pressure and vacuum test and just rule out any air leaks. So we've got the block off plate. I've done a video on these before, actually. Spark plug needs to go back in. And now lastly, I'm going to slip this plate in with some rubber on the underside for the exhaust to be sealed off. There's one more hole down here, which is your impulse hole. And again, that must be blocked, so I'm going to use a small screw. Just press that in place. We're ready to hook our Mighty Vac up now, and we'll see if it holds pressure and vacuum. We have got a slight leak. Very slight. Let's go see with some soapy water if we can find it. Start off around the adapter and that impulse hole. No bubbles that I can see anywhere there. And we still have that minor leak, so that leaves the exhaust port, seals, sealing surfaces, and the spark plug. Nothing out of the spark plug, that's holding tight. Let's try the exhaust port. I could actually hear it for a second there. I can still hear it. Sorry about the focus. I think it's actually my impulse screw is not sealing very well. Let's take that out and we'll change it. In instances like this, what I like to do is to actually put the Mighty Vac directly into the impulse hose, and we'll close off the one for the adapter, just using a pair of forceps. That's better, it's not leaking down now. So that was the issue, it just wasn't a very good seal using that bolt. At least it's holding pressure, and now we can move on to vacuum and just double check that the seals aren't compromised. That's at 20. And now what I like to do is to rotate the crankshaft, because that allows you to test whether the bearings have any play in them or whether the seals are slightly stiff and they only show that they're leaking with some movement. And that's gone right back to 20. So again, there's no pressure and vacuum leak. So we can rule out air leaks being the cause of this failure. That only really leaves an issue with the Entronic system. But typically when that has issues and starts to fail, it's the solenoids wearing out and they tend to let more fuel past. That really only leaves us with straight gas. Someone didn't put two-stroke oil in their mix, ran it, and that's what caused the seizure. Now, of course, I can't be certain, but with all the tests we've done so far, that's what it's looking like to me. It's remarkable just how far technology has come and how things like AI and ChatGPT can make a world of difference to almost any industry. Now, this machine obviously needs to be rebuilt, and I'll do that in another video. But if you want to know how chainsaws are repaired and rebuilt from the ground up, I've got this video for you next up here.